Fertility treatments can be broadly categorized in different ways. Some treatments, like Clomid and IUI, are non-invasive and relatively inexpensive. Others, like IVF, are more expensive and more invasive. In general, the pregnancy success rates with Clomid and IUI are a lot lower than the success rates with IVF. If you are looking to start fertility treatment, should you start with easy and inexpensive, knowing that the chance for success is lower, or should you go straight to IVF and take advantage of the much higher success rate? Stay tuned and I will explain. There are many reasons why people who are trying to conceive may need to go directly to IVF. For example, if infertility is due to persistent tubal blockage, IVF is the only way to become pregnant. When sperm are retrieved directly from the testicles, they are unable to fertilize eggs on their own, so IVF is again mandatory in this case. What if there weren't any identifiable problems, what fertility doctors refer to as unexplained infertility? These patients don't have to do IVF to conceive, but it is one option along with others. The most commonly used other option for couples with unexplained infertility is the use of the oral fertility medication clomiphene, or Clomid. Clomid is used in an attempt to mature multiple eggs at the same time. Close monitoring is performed in order to determine the exact day of ovulation. On that day, instead of having intercourse alone, sperm can be placed directly into the uterus. This is known as intrauterine insemination, or IUI. Clomid is a relatively inexpensive medication, and because it is a pill, it is easy to take. IUI is an inexpensive treatment that is no more uncomfortable than a pap smear. The advantages of this approach are ease and lower expense. The biggest downside of this approach is that it only increases the chance for pregnancy by a small amount. Each month, Clomid with IUI may give you a chance for pregnancy between 8 and 15%. The average is about 10%. Let's say 100 couples with unexplained infertility decided to try Clomid and IUI 4 times. After 1 month, about 10% of couples will have conceived, leaving 90 couples left. If all 90 attempt to use Clomid and IUI again, 10% of 90 means that 9 couples conceive in the second month. After 4 months of treatment, about 35 out of the original 100 couples will have conceived. The cumulative chance for pregnancy over 4 months is therefore 35%. In the USA, the cost for a Clomid IUI cycle can range from a few $100 to over $1,000, depending on where you live and what type of monitoring you use for ovulation. With IVF, injections of fertility medications are used to mature a large number of eggs. The eggs are aspirated from the ovaries, and a single sperm is injected into each egg. Any resulting embryos are kept in the laboratory for several days, and if they grow and develop normally, then they are frozen. After the following period, the uterus is prepared, an embryo is thawed, and placed into the uterus. For an average couple with unexplained infertility, the chance for pregnancy on that single embryo transfer could be in the 40 to 50% range or more. In other words, on average, more people become pregnant from a single attempt at IVF than with 4 attempts with Clomid and IUI. This is great in theory, but is there any real-life data? Actually, there is. Several years ago, doctors in Boston conducted a study called the FAST trial. In this study, doctors randomly allocated infertility patients to one of 2 groups. Group 1 did a traditional treatment where they started more conservatively with Clomid and IUI. Group 2 went directly to IVF. They found that the IVF group was able to get more people pregnant sooner than in the traditional treatment group. Our Infertility TV bottom line is this: if you have unexplained infertility, then there are options to start more conservatively or more aggressively. Each option has its pros and cons, but the direct-to-IVF method will get more people pregnant sooner. Infertility TV is your most trusted source for accurate information on infertility and miscarriage. If you are not a subscriber yet, hit the subscribe button right now. A new episode is released every week. Don't miss any episodes. You can also check us out on our website, IVF1.com, where you can become a patient.